Hi, today is 15 July 2020 and from today exactly 135 days is remaining for CAT 2020. And I am going to discuss two questions from geometry today. So let's start. Now the first question here, it says point B is on AC. So there is a line AC here. So let me mark the point. Let's say this is the point A and this is the point C. And somewhere there is a point B here. We can say, let's say this is point B. With AB equal to 9 and BC is equal to 21. Alright. So the length of AB is equal to 9 and the length of BC is equal to 21. Point D is not on AC, so that AD is equal to CD. So now AD equal to CD and D is not on the line AC. So I can say, let's say D is somewhere here. So let's say this is the point here, D. And the length AD, it is equal to CD. So we are getting nothing but it's an isosceles triangle. The length AD is equal to CD. And this distance is not given. So let's say this AD is equal to X and CD is also equal to X here. And both AD and CD are nothing but they are integers. That is also important here. Now, it says let S be the sum of all the possible perimeter of triangle ACD. Okay. So I need to find out all the possible perimeter of the triangle ACD here, and nothing else has been given. Now one more point which has been given here, that the length of BC is equal to 21 and AB is equal to 9. So for some reason the point B is also given. Otherwise I could have said, okay, these are the two lengths here, 2x here. Okay. And AD and BD are also integers. So AD and BD, so join B to D here. I can say, let's say B to D. So the length BD is also an integer. So I can say BD is also an integer. So let's mark BD as equal to Y. And BD is also integers. So here, what we can say, here BD is equal to Y. Now, since it is an isosceles triangle, and if I'm dropping a perpendicular in an isosceles triangle, so it will divide the side in two equal parts here. So let's say if I say this is the point P here, okay, and the total length of AC, it is equal to 21 plus 9, that is 30. Okay, the total length of AC is equal to 30. So the point P is nothing but the midpoint of the line AC. And if point P is the midpoint of the line AC, then the length from P to C, it is going to be equal to 15 here. So you can write down the length of PC, it is equal to 15. Yeah? Let me write down the length PC is equal to 15 here. And the BP will be comes out to be 6 here. Now, we know that the value of y, BD is also an integer. So x and y, the first important condition here is that is x and y, they are integers. So x and y are integers. Now, what about the length DP, let's say, which is the height h. Is it necessary that DP, which is equal to h, is an integer? No. Nothing has been given about this here. H can be in terms of fraction or it can be in terms of roots or anything. But x and y, they must be integer. So dp can be anything. So we cannot use the funda of the Pythagorean triplet also. Alright. Now, so what are the different possibilities here? So if you consider the two different triangles, again, now in triangle dpb, let me write down the triangle dbp. So on the basis of this, in triangle dpb, I can say definitely say y has to be greater than 6. Yes or no? Because it is the hypotenuse. Okay, so y has to be greater than 6. Similarly, in the triangle DPC, if we consider the triangle DPC, in the triangle DPC, DC is nothing but x, which is the hypotenuse. And the hypotenuse, it must be greater than 15 here. Because one of the length PC is 15, so x must be greater than 15. So I need to find out what are the possible values of x and y where they are integers. Yeah. So now, let's start here. Now, if we consider the triangle DBP, now, in triangle DBP, okay, in triangle DBP, I can say h square, that is h square plus 6 square, it is equal to y square, using the Pythagoras theorem. So, from here, I'll get that is h square, it is equal to nothing but that is y square minus 6 square here. Alright. Similarly, in the triangle DPC, in triangle DPC, use the Pythagoras theorem. So, by using Pythagoras theorem, I can say h square plus 15 square is equal to x square. So from here we can say that h square, it is equal to x square minus 15 square. Now equate these two equations. So if I equate these two equations, what will I get? Y square minus 6 square is equal to x square minus 15 square. So from here I can say that is x square minus y square is equal to 15 square minus 6 square. Now solve it here. X square minus y square is nothing but that is equal to x minus y into x plus y here. Alright. And 15 square minus 6, that is equal to, you can solve it here, that is 15 minus 6. 15 minus 6 is equal to 9, and 15 plus 6, that is 21. So 9 into 21, if you further factorize it, then I can say this will be equal to 3 cube into 7 here. Alright, that will comes out to be 3 cube into 7 here. So now again the question is here basically, in how many ways 3 cube into 7 can be written as a product of two factors here? Okay. And x plus y is definitely greater than x minus y. So what are the possibilities here? This is 9 into 21. This is also equal to nothing but that is 189. So write down this number as a product of two factors. When x minus y is 1 and x plus y is equal to 189. Okay. Now the next possibility is I'll say x minus y. X minus y is equal to 3 and x plus y, if I take it 3 as a factor, one of the factor, so 9 sevens are 63, so I'll get this is equal to 63. X minus y is equal to 7, and if it is equal to 7, then it will be comes out to be, that will be 3 square is 9, 9 threes are 27 here, alright. And then I can say, what is the else here, the one more factor here, that will be equal to 9, and this is 21. So 189 can be written as a product of two factors in these four ways exactly. Now, in all the cases, now remember here we need to find out that the values of x here. If the, what are the perimeter? The question says let s is the sum of the perimeter of triangle ACD. So if I need to find out the perimeter of the triangle ACD, so x has to be integer. So now we need to find out what are the possible values of x and y. Now we can do it here directly like first equation. Here x minus y is equal to 1 and x plus y it is equal to 189. Now if you add these two equations, if I add these two equations, what is the value of x? 189 plus 1 which is equal to 190 and 190 by 2. 190 by 2 it will be comes out to be how much? That is 95. So x will be equal to 95 and y is equal to 94. So this is definitely allowed. X is equal to 95 and 94. Similarly, under the second condition, that is 3 and 63, x minus y, it is equal to 3 and x plus y is equal to 63. Add these two equations and divide by 2. So I'll get, if I add these two, twice of x is equal to 66, so x will be, comes out to be 33. So x is equal to 33 and y is equal to nothing but that will be equal to how much? 30. So x is 33 and y is equal to 30. Similarly, the third case. From the third case, I can say x minus y, it is equal to 7 and x plus y is equal to 27. So add these two equations. So 27 plus 7 is 34 and the half of 34 is 17. So you'll get the value of x as 17 and then y is equal to nothing but that will be equal to 10 here. Okay, and all of them are satisfying. In the last case, I'll say x minus y is equal to 9 and x plus y is equal to 21. So if I add these two, so 21 plus 9 is 30 and half of 30 is 15. So x is equal to 15 and y is equal to nothing but 6. Now what are the conditions here? We know that x must be greater than 15 and y greater than 6. So check all the solutions here. So x should be greater than 15. So first case is satisfying and y is greater than 6. Second case is also satisfying. Even the third case is also satisfying, but the fourth case is not satisfying here. Because x equal to 15 is not possible. Otherwise, we will not get any triangle. So, there are three different triangles are possible under the different conditions. So, if there are three different triangles, then I need to find out the sum of perimeters also. So, let's find out what is the sum of the perimeters now. So, what is the perimeter? The perimeter of the triangle ACD. Okay. So, the perimeter of the triangle ACD is equal to side AC is 21 and the other two sides are x. So, 21 plus 2x. Okay, and I need to find out what are the different perimeter here. So it will be comes out to be 21 plus 2x. This is the for one triangle. Okay, so I can say if, sorry, this is not 21, but this is 30 here. The length AC is equal to 30. So I can say 30 plus 2x. So one of the side is going to be 30 plus 2 into 95. All right. The other, one of the perimeter, the other perimeter, that is 30 plus 2 into 33. As we are getting three triangles, and the third possible perimeter is 30 into 2 into 70. And add all these values. So if you add all these values, you'll get the final answer, which will be comes out to be 380. And that is the correct answer. So I hope that this question is clear to all of you. In case, still, if there is any doubt, you can post your doubt in the comment section and I'll reply. Alright, now let's move to the next question quickly. That is question number 41. Okay. So you all can pause the video and try to solve this question, and then you can start looking for solution. Now it says, let ABCD is an isosceles trapezium. So I say ABCD is an isosceles trapezoid. So here it is an isosceles trapezoid with AB equal to 6 and BC is equal to 5 and DA and CD are 4. So AB is equal to 6. All right. And the length of BC, it is equal to 5 and CD is equal to 4 and DA is also equal to 5. Okay. Now draw circles of radius 3 centered at A, B and circles of radius centered at C and D. A circle contained within the trapezium like here is tangent to all of these four bigger circles. And we need to find out its radius. Okay, its radius is minus k plus m root n by p. So we know that here the radius is nothing but it is a, it will comes out to be in terms of irrational number. So we need to find out its radius basically. So there are four circles, all these four circles are touching each other and we need to find out the radius of the circle here. Okay, so now what can we do here in this case? As all the circles are touching each other, so I can say this radius, radius of each of the circle is 3. Alright, so radius of this circle is equal to 3. Okay, I can say this is also 3. This is equal to 3. Radius of this circle is 2 and 2 and 2 and 3. Okay, now we do not know what is the radius of the circle, the middle circle. Okay, but let me mark this is nothing but this is my center O. So what is the length of OA? So this is equal to 3 and this is equal to R. This is equal to 2 and this is equal to R. So we can say for one thing we are sure that the length OA, OA is equal to nothing but that is 3 plus R. Alright. And the length OD, OD is equal to nothing but R plus 2. So OA is equal to 3 plus R and OD is equal to nothing but that will be comes out to be equal to R plus 2 here. Alright. Now, so OA is equal to 3 plus R and OD is equal to R plus 2. Now, another thing which I need to do it here is once we identify the length of OA as well as the OD. Okay. Now, if I mark this as the point P and this is the point Q. Okay. So, P is the point of tangency here. So, this angle is nothing but 90 degrees. So, in triangle OAP, if I consider the triangle OAP. Okay. Or I can say APO. So, in triangle APO, apply the Pythagoras theorem. So I'll get 3 square plus OP square and that is equal to nothing but that is going to be equal to 3 plus R whole square. Okay, 3 plus R whole square. So from here we'll get that the value of OP, OP is equal to what? Solve this equation. So I'll get OP, or let's solve it. This is 3 square is equal to 9 plus OP square, which is equal to 9 plus 6 R plus R square. So 9 and 9 will get cancelled. So from here I'll get that the length of OP, it will be equal to root of 6R plus R square. Okay. Now similarly consider the triangle ODQ. Okay, ODQ. Now if we consider the triangle ODQ, again it's a right angle triangle. Okay. So in triangle ODQ, okay, I can say the length of DQ, which is 2 square, DQ square, plus OQ square. OQ square, we do not know what is the length of OQ, so OQ square. And that will be equal to 2 plus R whole square. Now, if you solve this, I'll get 2 square is equal to 4 plus OQ square. And that will be equal to 2 square is 4 plus R square plus 4R. So, from here, we can find out what is the length of OQ. Alright. And what is the length of OQ? the length of OQ, it will be comes out to be equal to how much? That will be 4r plus r square, root of 4r plus r square. Okay. Now, what is the length of OP plus OQ? Okay, if you see the length of OP plus OQ, so we are talking about this line here, that is PQ. So the length of OP plus OQ, this is nothing but that is PQ. And PQ is basically the height of the trapezium. So the length OP plus OQ, it is equal to, I can say PQ, which is nothing but that is height of trapezium. Okay, height of trapezium. And what is this height of a trapezium? I can say this height of the trapezium, it is equal to nothing but OP plus OQ. So which is the sum of these two numbers here? Alright. So if you add these two here, which will be comes out to be equal to how much? So I can say the length of OP plus OQ. Alright. So you can add these two. And okay, I'll add here later on. Okay. Now, another thing here. How to find the height of this trapezium? Now, it's an isosceles trapezium. So, it's an isosceles trapezium. So, if I drop, if you look at here, I drop a perpendicular from point D. So, drop a perpendicular from point D like this here, like this. Okay, like this. Okay, and drop a perpendicular from point C also. You can see here. Or if it's not needed, if I drop a perpendicular from point D on line AB, so I can say, let me say this is the point equal to OPQR. I can say, let's say this is the point X, or this is the point X. So what is the length AX is equal to? I can say X to P is equal to 2. Okay, total. And so AX is equal to 1. Now AX is equal to 1. So in triangle DAX, if you consider in triangle DAX, in triangle DAX, again, it's a right angle triangle. Okay. So I can find out the length dx. So dx square plus ax square, which is 1 square, which is equal to 5 square. So from here dx, and dx is equal to nothing but root 24. And what is dx? Dx is equal to height of trapezium. Alright. So dx is the height of trapezium. So we know the height of the trapezium is equal to root 24. And we also know that the height of a trapezium is equal to OP plus OQ. So we can use these two facts here. So let me do the calculations here. So we know the length OP. OP is equal to 6R plus root of 6R plus R square. And OQ is equal to, we also know that is equal to root of 4R plus R square. And equate this with equal to root 24. And then solve that equations. Alright. So let me do it quickly here. So you'll get a quadratic equation, and you just need to solve those quadratic equations. Okay. Now that's done. Alright. So you know that OP plus OQ, it is equal to height of trapezium. And DX root 24 is also height of trapezium. OP is non, OQ is non. So both are non. So I can equate this. That is root of 6R plus R square plus root of 4r plus r square, and that is equal to root 24. So you just need to solve this equation and you'll get a quadratic equation. Alright. So how to solve this equation? By squaring. So if you take a square, okay, then you can solve this and you'll get a, all the terms will be get cancelled. You need to take a square twice, remember. Okay. So solve this, you'll get a quadratic equation. You need to take a square twice here, and once you solve it, you'll get the value of r after solving that quadratic equation. I'm writing it directly. Make sure that you know how to solve this equation. So r is equal to nothing but that will be equal to minus 60 plus 48 root 3 upon 23. So this is the final value of r which you will get here. Minus 60 plus 48 root 3 upon 20 here. Okay, and this is the answer. So this is the value of minus k plus m root n p here. So in the exam, if they ask you the radius, this will be the answer. But here it was asked, find the value of k plus m plus n plus p. Okay, where all of them are, the k and p are relatively prime. So make sure that the equation is in the simplest possible form here. So you can find out all these values. So let me write down these values here. The value of k, it is equal to minus 60. okay, m is equal to 48 and n is equal to nothing but that is equal to 3 and the value of p is equal to 23. All right, so these are the values here. Okay, k is not minus 60, only plus 60, because minus k, so minus 60, so k is 60. Add these two values, all these four values, and you'll get the answer as 134. So this is the correct answer. So I hope that this is clear to all of you. So that's all for today.